Hello, kiddos. I have a bag full of mysterious stories. One of them, the Bubble Bear's Adventure. Yes, story of a bear. Have you ever seen a bear? Bubble Bear had long, black, shiny fur with not even a single white hair on it. He was very naughty, loved by everyone in the jungle. Like any other kid, he would run and jump around the jungle whole day, and his mother would call after him. Bubble, Bubble, you will get hurt. Bubble, take rest, she would say, but he would ignore and continue playing. This story is about one such night when everyone in the jungle was fast asleep, but Bubble couldn't. He was still too excited to sleep, as questions buzzed in his mind like restless butterflies. Where did the sun sleep at night? Who was Moon's mother? When, how, what, where? He thought, and when he couldn't take it any longer, he slowly slipped out of the den and sat outside, releasing and enjoying the whoosh, whoosh of trees and kit, kit of crickets. But his mind was still filled with his dream to be famous one day, his dream to make the Himalayan bears known worldwide. But how? His eyes shone with excitement as he saw the deodara tree, so long and so tall as if touching the sky. He ran towards the jungle, and when he finally stood in front of the tree, he was sure that he would be the first bear ever to reach the moon. He started climbing the tree slowly, slowly. As he climbed higher and higher, the branches got thinner and thinner, but he did not mind much. And that was when he was on the peak, he realized. Do you know what he realized? Well, the moon was still far, far away from him. He decided to get down slowly. But suddenly he heard weird noises. Kir, kir, krak! Mummy, he screamed. Dab! He fell down. Silence. No rustle. No sound. On the other hand, his mother, who woke up from a deep sleep, got worried when she did not see Bubble beside her. Bubble! Bubble! She screamed as she ran towards the jungle. And there she saw him, lying on the cold, wet jungle floor. She ran towards him and turned him over, and for the first time saw him silence. No movement. Still. She cried and cried until she noticed a long thread on her paw. She looked towards the moon and it gave her a wink, as if telling her to hurry up. She immediately threaded the pine needle to the moonbeam and started to sew Bubble's chest. And as the last stitch was put on his chest, Bubble opened his eyes.
Mummy, mummy, I'm sorry, mummy, mummy, I'm sorry. The tree, the dream, the moon,
he said, but she kept crying, this time out of happiness that he was safe in her embrace. By this time, everyone had gathered around the jungle and they screamed in excitement as they saw the shining V on his chest. He was looking the most handsomest and beautiful bear of the jungle. And all the bears wanted the same V on their chests. Bubble's mother looked towards the moon, and the moon gave her a nod and smiled. She started to sew Bubble's chest, and suddenly their eyes went on the moon.
We have taken so many moonbeams that the moon has become pale and thin, they cried.
But the moon just smiled in excitement and said, no worries, my friend. Just a few days and I would be fine, he said. They all were happy. And today also, when you go to the zoo and ever look at Himalayan bears, you will see the shining V on their chests. This is why they say, if we want to be successful in life, we have to be passionate and hardworking.